Having learned use of preposition between and among in our previous session, today we are going to learn the use of preposition of time, for and since. So all of you, open your book chapter 32 at page number 119.
Before starting, let me quickly recapitulate our previous session.
Between versus among. As we have already discussed, between is used when we talk about two persons or things, whereas among is used when we talk about more than two persons or things. We are going to discuss their examples one by one. Between. The map is between the palm tree and the hut. We are talking about two things, palm tree and the hut, so we use between here. I am trying to decide between the green shirt and the black shirt. Here we are talking about two things, the green shirt and the black shirt, so we use between here. On the flight, I sat between Michael and David. We talk about two boys, Michael and David, so we use between here. Second, among. Share these sweets among your friends. We are talking about many friends, so we use among. Second, the wolf was hiding among the trees. Many trees, so among. Third one, Rhea shared the cake among her classmates. We are not talking about one classmate. She is going to share her cake with many students, means with full class, so among. Now today we are going to start with prepositions of time. Prepositions can also be used to give us an idea of the time when an action took place. For example, I will meet you at 5 o'clock. Second, I have not seen him for a long time. Third, I have lived here for 2 months. Now in these three examples, at, for and for is telling you, is giving you an idea of the time that when that action took place. So, this is your preposition of time.
Today, we are going to discuss two prepositions of time, for and since. And we are going to discuss the use of for and since one by one. For, we use for to talk about a length of time, a period of time.
It means from the start of the period to the end of period. So we use for when we talk about a period of time. Let us see their examples. Jane has worked here for 10 years. Now 10 years is a period of time that from the start of the period till the end of the period he worked here. So we use for there. Second, we will visit Spain for 2 weeks. 2 weeks is a period of time, so we use for. Mark lived in London for 6 months. Now 6 months is a period of time given in a sentence, so we use for.
He reads for 2 hours every day.
2 hours is a period of time, so we use for. Second, I had studied French for 5 years. 5 years is a period of time given in a sentence, so we use for. Third, I haven't seen you for a week. A week given is a period of time, so we use for. Fourth, they have been studying in this school for 6 years. 6 years is a period of time given in a sentence, so we use for. Now let us discuss since. We use since if we have to calculate the point of time, that is from a particular time or event in the past until the present, or in that period of time. So when we talk about point of time, we use since. For example, I have lived here since 1983. Now here we are talking a point of time that I am living here since 1983. Second, I have been studying in this school since 2008. Means I am talking about that I am studying in this school from past till present. I am telling a point of time, so I use since here. He has been watching TV since 7 p.m. Let us look out more examples. Mark had been writing a book since 2010. Point of time is given, so since. My parents have lived in London since 1996. This 1996 is a point of time, means from past till present we are talking about, so since. Third, she has been a teacher since 1993. Point of time is given, so since. Rahul has been wanting this since last July. Now point of time is given, so since. So till now we have learned what is a preposition. A preposition is a word that indicates the position or relation of a noun or pronoun with another noun or pronoun or verb in a sentence. So preposition is a word that indicates the position or the relation. We have also discussed use of preposition on, over and above. On is used when one thing is touching the surface of the other. Over is used when one thing is covering the other thing. And last one, above is used in a higher position. So on, over and above is used depending upon how high or the object or person is. We have also discussed the use of preposition under, below and beneath. Here, under is used when one thing is covered by something or it is directly below. Below is used at a lower level. And third one, beneath is used when something is situated directly below as if hidden, covered or protected. As you can see in the picture, cat is standing under the tree. Whereas roots grow below the ground. Third one, the treasure is buried beneath the earth's surface. So we use under, below and beneath depending on how much below the object or person is. And today we have learned use of preposition of time for and since. For is used when we talk about a period of time and since is used when we talk about a point of time. So now you people need to revise your chapter 32 prepositions and need to work as per the schedule of your SNAP homework and solve the exercises related to it. Goodbye. Thank you.